The following is a technical analysis on Airbnb Incorporated, a company of the technology sector, internet content, and information here off the 1 hour interval. Whereas I will begin the scale and out process where we have this concealed uptrend line. I've added this new benefit of doubt secondary uptrend line with plenty of continuous reactionary lows to strengthen the validation of. We ended up, what had happened is we broke down here, ended up having a bear trap, false reaction, back tested against it one, two more times, ended up breaking above it. Whereas I found this new concealed primary downtrend line, a hidden downtrend line off the daily interval, where I had mentioned as an additional scale in short there, and we ended up back testing it, gapped down, looked like we were going to start selling off there. Back tested it one more time, three reactionary highs in total off that trading sequence, and then had a complete backfill of the gap there, knocked my 129.08 price support to the button, and bull traders, dip buyers ended up defending this key inflection point heavily for 7% in gains there. And within the purpose of this video is also showing you, really teaching you my scaling out process and when to let go of a trade here, whereas I'm already down, call it a 3%. On a 3% stop loss, where I am starting to initialize the scaling out process at least up to a 5% stop loss. And once we hit that 5% range, which will be, call it around 140, 140, 73, 140, 80, almost 141, versus that, it would have been a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio down to 122.84 for 8.4% drop, down to 116.10 for 13.6% crash. Which would have been close to a 3-to-1 risk reward ratio on this short trade setup. And talk about a move that's just blasting the upside, taking out that series of resistance. Here is the primary concealed reactionary downtrend line here off the gap off of 2021's all-time highs here. And you could just tell the velocity of that breakout, the velocity of the shorts that are just being squeezed out from that key inflection point is just further validated there. And again, just had an upgrade, some pretty good solid news. Health indicators are starting to look pretty healthy here with a confirmed bullish cross over here on the moving average convergence. And again, that's something you don't want to be short in the long run. And take away the lines, I'll zoom out even further to the weekly interval. And here we have a well-identified inverse head and shoulder bottom where you have your nice clean shoulder here, head followed by your right shoulder, starting to peak above the neckline of that primary. So if we have that, weekly solid candle close here, and we begin to get stopped out on that minus 5% range, where I'll scale out entirely out of my position, you have healthy momentum and technical momentum indicators here on the weekly interval as well. Bullish crossovers on the moving average convergence and oscillator, and again, just correlated with that daily interval, where just a strong candle pop right above that level, which validated that that hidden trend line was just a very powerful inflection point. We'll see what happens again. Very close to being stopped out in a full entirety, even though we still have this here on the skin of its teeth. We have some of these negative and bearish divergences that are starting to just construct on a much larger scale here. And again, that is it'll start to burn out here. Once we pop this level of this RSI resistance and the moving average convergence, those negative and bearish divergences will be completely burned out here, including the divergent high, and then a much more profound move to the upside, in my opinion, with that inverse head and shoulder weekly technical structure. I'll keep you updated if I see any more significance in the charts. These are some short stop out strategies to closely monitor. And when I have a losing trade, I simply move on.
When I have a winning trade, I simply move on. But when I have a winning trade, I press my winners. It means that the really big winners that I have may only be about 10 out of every 100 trades. That really makes a big difference psychologically. That's a very difficult way of trading because the vast majority of people will maximize the amount of winning trades rather than maximizing the amount they make on each trade.